Hello, and welcome to section 6. This section 6 is very interesting. It is titled Profiting from Your Problems. Profiting from Your Problems. Right now, I have, expressed three formula for solving problems: spiritual formula, psychological formula, and intelligent formula. Right now, we are going deeper into the course by looking at this section, how to profit from your problems. You see, the problem actually came to destroy you. The problem came to frustrate you. And maybe even the problem came to make you to die untimely. But right now, using, spiritual formula, the psychological formula, and the intelligent formula, you need to now be able to turn the problem around and bring something out of that problem. And that is why we are looking at how to profit, from the problem. Hallelujah. Now, this is lesson 30. And in this lesson 30, I'm speaking about conquering your problem. You need to understand that the problem is supposed to be conquered by you. The book of Luke chapter 10 verse 19 says, "Behold, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." Our Lord and Master Jesus Christ said this word. This is a fundamental word to everyone that believes in God, everyone that believes in Jesus Christ. He said, "I'm giving you power to tread on serpents." Serpents are problems. They are difficulties that we may encounter in our journey of life. But God said, "I give you power to ride over them." He said to defeat them, to bring them under. And that is why Psalm 110 verse 2 says, "The Lord will send the rod of your strength out of Zion. Rule thou in the midst of your enemies." The power to rule in the midst of your enemies is delivered to you, is given to you. You see, when God made you, he gave you fivefold blessing. Genesis chapter 1 verse 28 says, "And God blessed them, and God said, be fruitful." So whatever you are doing, God has blessed you to be fruitful. So you need to be fruitful. Multiply, replenish the earth, subdue the earth, and have dominion. These are the blessings of God for you. So no matter the problem you face, the problem you are going through, you have power to subdue them because God gave you power. And that is why it is wrong for a problem to bow you down. It is wrong for a problem to overcome you. It is out of place when problem jubilates over you and succeed to make you sad all your life. You are not created to be poor. You are not created to be a loser. You are not created to be at the mercy of the circumstances. You are created to be above the circumstances. You are created to be the head and not the tail. I want you to understand that this is what God has in plan for you. See, because God created you to be undefeatable. You see, I wrote something here which I want to read for you because I want you to understand what I am really saying. You see, God, man has always defeated any problem that came to man. Problems that came into the human life has always been defeated. There was a time, when somebody is down with malaria, is a death sentence. There was no solution. But man conquered it, proposed solution, and now malaria fever can be easily cured. HIV was a dreaded disease. There was no cure for HIV. Even though now there is no cure, but there are solutions in place for HIV now that put HIV to rest, that you can live with HIV for the rest of your life and still live a normal life. Because man is thinking, man has preferred solution to that dread disease. You see, you can prefer solution to your problem. The power to do it is inside you. You can do it. Go out there and do it. It is well with your soul. I'll see you in the next lecture.